Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator Advanced course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Also, there's a link in the description for the exercise files. Those are free to download, so go and download those. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there, in this video, we're going to look at distorting and pulling and pushing using Illustrator's Envelope Distort. We're gonna turn our gradient into some kind of weird looking fish, and we're gonna combine the bottom two graphics to turn them into a love heart. Oh. All right, let's go and do that now in Adobe Illustrator. Oh yeah, little side note, at the beginning of this tutorial, I forget to tell you to open up the file called Envelope Distort.ai. It's in your exercise files. Do that first, all right? See you in there. Okay, so to make our envelope distortions, we're gonna start with this guy at the top here. You can use anything, okay? It has to be vector though, okay? It can't be a picture. That's a Photoshop job. So with all of this selected, I'm going to go to Object and I'm gonna go down to Envelope Distort. And we're gonna look at all of these. We're gonna look at the first one here called Make with Warp. Now warp is kind of like just some basic, predefined styles. So arc, okay, make sure preview's on. Arc, I'm not gonna go through every single one of them, except my favorite. Where is he? Fish, okay, and there is some adjustments you can do with these guys, okay, deciding on what you wanna do. And it's just like, if I had to draw that with a pen tool, I'd go insane. So there's some cool uses of this. Fish, maybe not, but you know, there's some cool stuff in here. So that's how to do that. And one thing that will happen though is if I click out and click back in, like how do I get back in there? You can go over here to Warp Options, okay, which is the newer version of Illustrator. Otherwise you can click on it and up the top here, it's kind of spread out along here, but you can say, actually, I'd like to go back to my favorite, really, fish and vertical fish, okay, and all the options along the top there. The next one I want to show you is over there, fishy, is using a shape to distort it. So I'm going to grab some type, click once, and I'm going to type, I love you. Oh, there's a heart and stuff, you know. I'm going to use this font here called Hubris. I can't even spell it. Is that Hubris? I can't say that. Anyway, it's a cool font. It's on Typekit. It's free to use. Well, it's commercial, but it's free as part of your Creative Cloud license. I'm going to use this because it looked kind of cool. I'm going to use my shortcuts to play with the leading. Now, the best bit is to play around with your tracking and leading, everything before it gets into the heart because it's going to be problematic. I'm holding down the Alt key on a PC or an Alt key, Option key on a Mac, and just using my up arrow to play with the leading or line spacing. Okay, so I'm happy with that, right? Now I'm going to get it kind of roughly to the right shape. Don't worry about too much because the first thing that needs to happen is that the shape that you want to use to, you know, bend the text with needs to be at the front. Okay, select both of them and go to Object, Envelope Distort, and that's why it needs to be on top. Mesh, make with top object. Cool, huh? Kind of bends it in there. What I might do before I do that is copy and paste it, or copy it at least. Do the Envelope Distort, and then I get to paste Command F to put it straight where I got it from, or Control F on a PC. I might send that to the back, and I might do something with it just to kind of, I feel like it's being lost a little bit in there. All right, you can do it with any shape on top. The more complex it is, the more kind of chance of it going a bit crazy, but give it a go. We're gonna look at that last one in the next video, okay, which was make with mesh. We'll do that in the next video because it's a little bit longer and a little bit more detailed. All right, let's check it out in the next video. Hey there, I hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up. It really helps out what I do. I've got lots of other stuff here on YouTube, so consider subscribing. Also, I wanna see what you made. Okay, so you're obviously doing something. Don't be shy. I'd love to see what it is. If you put it up on Instagram, I'd love to, for you to mention me. I'm Bring Your Own Laptop on Instagram. And on Twitter, I'm Dan Loves Adobe. Also, if you like my teaching style and you want more advanced Illustrator stuff, there's the full course. Okay, it's on bringyourownlaptop.com. There'll be a link in the description. Also on Bring Your Own Laptop is there's a resources tab and there's a free cheat sheet in there. Free, totally downloadable. It has all the kind of, we did the keyboard shortcuts and stuff for Illustrator. It's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer. It's awesome. All right, continue on. Bye now.